It's Wednesday, May 12th here in Seoul. Hey everyone, it's Debbie from Korea Now with the headlines for today.
South Korean web giants Kakao and Naver are moving to expand their business globally. On Tuesday, Kakao Entertainment said it has acquired two US-based startups, Tapas and Radish, for $510 million and $440 million US, respectively. Tapas is a webtoon service based in San Francisco, and Radish is a web novel service from New York. And the founder and CEO of Radish, Lee Sung-yoon, even made it on Forbes 30 Under 30 Asia list in 2016 when he founded the company at the age of 25. He also grew his company's revenue by tenfold from 2019 to 2020. This comes after Naver recently announced its acquisition of Wattpad, a self-publishing fiction app from Canada, for about $600 million. The United States may consider sharing COVID-19 vaccines with North Korea upon request. That's according to CNN on Tuesday, which noted that sharing the vaccines may help resume dialogue with the North. But no request for assistance has been made so far, according to a senior U.S. official who also said Washington is open to provide humanitarian aid to Pyongyang. Meanwhile, the U.S. recently offered to explain the outcome of its policy review on North Korea to Pyongyang, and the North reportedly responded by saying the proposal has been well received. This was a different reaction from when the U.S. made its first attempt under President Biden to engage with Pyongyang back in February, but the regime did not respond. Seoul's Unification Ministry said it has a positive view on U.S. efforts to reach out to North Korea to create opportunities for dialogue at an early date. South Korean pharmaceutical giant Celltrion has begun exporting its antibody treatment for COVID-19 around the globe. The company said it signed a contract with a state-run company in Pakistan to export 100,000 tablets of Regirona, which is enough for 30,000 people. Celltrion also said it's currently in talks with other countries in Europe and South America, as well as India, to export its antibody treatment. Regirona got a conditional approval from Korea's Drug Safety Ministry in February, becoming the first locally made treatment for COVID-19. However, the ministry did not grant conditional approval for a plasma treatment developed by GC Pharma after a second phase clinical trial failed to prove its effects against COVID-19.
And those are your top stories. For full link articles, you can check out our official website, linked down below. As always, make sure to subscribe to Korea Now for more daily updates.